Hey there, and welcome to what we are now calling Todoist Tutor. And this show is where we sort of take real users' setups and see what we can do with them, either to improve them, praise them, or get them unstuck from where they are now. Today, we are going to have April, who probably represents 90% of Todoist users out there. They download the app, they start adding tasks, and then, well, let's hear it straight from April herself.
Hey there. So here is my Todoist layout. Essentially, I tend to jump around a lot. So I have a fantastical calendar that's working really well for me, and I have Todoist. And what I want to do is, whether I'm looking at both or using one more primarily than the other, I really want this to house all my information. So this is what I have so far. I've like read some articles and things, and I've made some like labels and some hashtags as far as like things that would be important for me. My inbox, you know, it's kind of just random things I've thought of here or there. But ideally, I think what I'm looking for is like, what are the essential things for me to open up Todoist and like really be clear on like what's most important for the day, getting a snapshot of what's going on for the week, and then being able to capture projects and ideas to where they don't just get lost in the shuffle. I think the filtering could be really good for me. And again, I read your articles, but I don't use them yet. That's probably on me. I don't think there's anything that I don't think it's a technical issue. I think it's just me making these filters and labels work. I haven't set up any filters, but these are the labels that I have. And again, I think there's all these features. I think what I need help is, like, I'm a beginner. I'm going to lay the foundation for something that I can utilize it well every day, and then, you know, add the layers of the features over time. So this is what it is. Appreciate the time, and just let me know any insights you have on how I can really allow Todoist to work for me.
I totally get it, April. You're looking at all these features, filters, labels, different views, and you feel like you should be using every single one of them to get the best setup. But here's the thing, you don't need to master everything on day one or day 10, right? In fact, trying to do that is probably what is keeping you stuck right now. So let's have a look at what we can do. The issue is not that you don't know how to use Todoist now. You're actually doing the hardest part. You're capturing everything and you're putting it into the inbox. So look at this. Tasks are flowing in. Your brain is starting to get used to that process. And it starts to essentially trust that system that you're developing. The real problem is what we can call feature overwhelm. We show you everything that Todoist has available, and you start to feel a sense of pressure that you need to use all of it immediately. April, you mentioned wanting basically one place to see what needs to be done today. Perfect. That is what we're going to focus on building here. Forget everything else for now. We're going to focus on this three simple steps: capture, clarify, and complete. Capture, you're already nailing this. Keep doing what you're doing. Put everything into the inbox. It can be random thoughts, work deadlines, grocery lists, books that someone suggests to you. Everything, in it goes. Clarify, this is where we're going to sort of develop some of this today. Once a day, maybe with your morning coffee, tea, water, whatever it is that you like to do, spend 5 minutes going through your inbox, and you're going to ask yourself, when do I need to do this? And you'll put that date on the task, and even if it needs a time, we'll put that on there as well. And if it is sort of related to an area of your life, that's when we can also put it into a project. Last, we have complete. Head to your today view and focus purely on what actually needs your attention right now. That's it. No filters, no complex labels, no overthinking it. Okay, so let me show you exactly what this looks like. Here's an inbox that is similar to what you have, April. Okay, so call dentist. I need to do this tomorrow morning. So I'm going to type tomorrow, 9 a.m., and hit enter. Now it's scheduled and will show in the Today view, but tomorrow. Plan a weekend trip. This one isn't urgent, but I do want to work on it this weekend. So when I type in the task, I'm going to add Saturday. And again, hit enter. Done. One-time task project. April, we love that you already had this created. It's good for tasks that don't sort of have anywhere specific that they need to be. So I'll move this task here by typing hash one-time tasks and again hitting enter. So see how each task, we're just spending a few seconds kind of processing it. You're not organizing your entire life. You're just answering, when do I need to think about this again? And putting that information in. All right, so here's the magic, April. Take a look at your Today view. Here's the task that you need to action today. Everything you've scheduled is going to live here alongside your calendar events, because we saw that you have integrated your calendar with Todoist as well. And then in upcoming view, that's your weekly forecast. You can see, well, what's coming without feeling overwhelmed by everything appearing in another view. And this is exactly what you asked for, that one place to focus on what matters now. I know it might feel like you're not using Todoist properly, right? Because you're not using all of these features. But here's kind of a little secret, or something we have found works the best with Todoist. It's not about using all of the features. The most successful users are the ones that have consistent habits in doing it. And April, you're already there with capturing your task consistently. That's easily the hardest part of this. Now you just need to build the habit of clarifying what those tasks are. And once that feels natural, every day checking that list, maybe in a few weeks' time, then you can start to have a look at exploring labels, if there's something that you want to categorize, or filters if you eventually want a custom view. But for right now, this simple system will handle everything you're needing. April, here's some homework just for you. Keep capturing everything in your inbox. You're nailing this part already. Then let's create a recurring task to spend 5 minutes going through your inbox every day. Check what's in there, clarify it. Use Today View as your home base. You can even set this as the default if you want to. Let's ignore labels and filters for now. You can even hide that from the settings menu if you're finding it sort of distracting or it pulls you in there. And then give this system, say, 2 weeks, even more if you like, before changing anything about it. And then our mantra coming out of this, capture, clarify, and complete. April, you are not behind. Far from it, actually. You're exactly where you need to be here on this journey. Let us know if this simplified approach leaves you feeling a little more in control and calm, relaxed with your Todoist setup. You're doing great, just stick with it. And if anyone else has a Todoist setup that they even want to like talk about or get unstuck with, send a video of your setup to fixmysetup@todoist.com and you might end up in one of the future videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.